Hello guys, it's Adam B Live here with the tutorial on how to create that dub sound bass or dub sub bass sound for your production. I'm gonna start a new project real quick. And I'm gonna put in an operator. At the same time, I'm gonna put a drum kit. And I'm gonna put my personal drum kit. And I'm gonna put in kick sound. Let's put in 808 because it's pretty subby 808 sound. On the one, the two. To the real deep sub sound. Thank you. put more attack into it so it won't have to sound with these clicking sounds.
Throw in, I'm gonna throw in the virus.
it right now. I'm going to go to default again. That's how I do most of my tracks when I start off. I will sometimes put a compressor in some of these like instances. Right now there's nothing going on. I mean, I can continue experimenting once I have this. I put a compressor in. Let's hear how that sounds. Experimenting. So just to talk about the basic of the deep sub, the deep sound that you hear sometimes in those bass sound is mostly in combination of the kicks and the bass on this. Like the bass is just this sound. But if you hear the kick now, gives it like a nice little thump in between. Experiment with the pitch. But that's basically how I start doing all my stuff. That clicking sound, you won't get it at all. You can bring down the resolution on that. Sometimes it's between the decay. But it's all, you know, you wouldn't hear it. This kind of help you guys in trying to get that deep bass sound on using just operator. You can use a sampler, just playing with the waveform. I'll probably do a tutorial with sampler or simpler to get the same kind of effect of sub bass sound, but mostly dub techno and dub bass. And dub is all about deep bass as much as you can get out of, and at the same time with the kick drum as well. I mean, if I was to put the hat, the clap or hat, whatever I want, let's put this right here. See how that sounds. This was a little bit of a tutorial. I mean, I've been so busy with doing my multiple projects that I have going on, and I'll probably keep on giving you some nice tips about playing around with these kind of, you know, in production. I mean, I'm pretty much busy, but I hope this was a nice little tutorial. I mean, I've been out for a while, but I'll try to keep on maintaining myself and giving you some tips and tricks. Take care. Have a good one. Peace.